Suppose there are infinite number of lines on the floor which are at a distance of L from each other. We have to drop a noodle of length T on the floor. This noodle may or may not intersect with any of these lines. A noodle may have more than one intersection with more than one line also. We have to find the probable number of intersections. This problem is known as Buffon's noodle problem. In this video, we will explain about probable events also, and in the end of this video, we will solve Buffon's needle problem with the help of Buffon's noodle problem. You are watching Brain Explorers, the world where brain starts working. Probable event or expected event is the average of infinite number of events. Probable event may or may not belong to the set of events. For example, probable number on throwing a die is 3.5. Let's see how. Suppose we get 6 on throwing a die and we get 2 sixes again in the same row. This is included in the example to show that pattern do not affect the probable event. After this, 1, 3, 4, 5 and other number occur randomly. Let's now calculate the average by making a frequency distribution table. 1 occurred 6 times, 2 occurred 7 times, and frequencies of other numbers are mentioned in their front. In total, there are 39 observations. Using the formula sigma fx over sigma f, their average comes out to be 3.46. It is not exactly equal to 3.5 because number of observations are not infinite. As we increase the number of observations, their average gets closer to the probable value and average of infinite observations become equal to the probable value. If number of observations have to be infinite, then the frequencies of all variable must also be infinite, but it doesn't mean that all are equal. You can imagine them as very large different numbers. In this data set, F1 is the frequency of X1, which means it is the favorable outcome of X1, and sigma F is the total number of outcomes. This means F1 over sigma F is the probability of event X1. Similarly, F2 over sigma F is the probability of event X2. In this way, we find that probable value or expected value is x1 times probability of x1 plus x2 times probability of x2 and so on. We will use this result later. Now, suppose there is a needle which intersects with these lines 43 times in 200 attempts. If there are two such needles and we drop them together 200 times, then how many intersections do you expect? Obviously 86. If number of needles are doubled, number of intersections get doubled. Same number of intersections will be observed if these two needles are joined together. Each half of the combined needle will have 43 intersections. Sometimes both the parts may intersect simultaneously, and sometimes more than two intersections are also possible if needles are long enough. In general, if a needle intersects n times in m attempts, then a combination of a such needles is expected to be intersect na times in m attempt. If this combination is formed by infinitesimally small needles, then it will become a noodle. Mathematically, we can say that if et is the probable number of intersections of a noodle of length t, then the probable number of intersections of a noodle of length AT is A times ET. This result is not a general result of expected value. It is valid only for the particular problems. Since this result does not vary with the shape of the noodle, so we can choose any convenient shape of the noodle. Let's take a circle of diameter L. Its length is pi L. But here it is clear that whatever is the position of the circular noodle, it will intersect exactly 2 times. Therefore, its probable number of intersections is 2. On taking the average of many 2s also, we get 2. but we have to find the probable number of intersections of a noodle of length t. So multiply and divide by t inside e and take pi l over t outside e. Using our result, we get et equals to 2t over pi l. This is the solution of Buffon's noodle problem. Using this, let us solve Buffon's needle problem. Assume a needle of length t where t is less than l. Since needle is small, thus it cannot intersect more than once at a time. Probable number of intersections is 2t over pi l, which is equal to 1 times probability of one intersection plus 2 times probability of two intersections and so on. This needle cannot intersect 2 or more times, so p2, p3, p4 becomes 0. We get probability of intersections equal to 2t over pi l. If you want to know the probability of intersection of a long needle, then you can watch our another video on Buffon's needle problem. Don't forget to like and share our video, and for more such videos, subscribe to our channel Brain Exploders. Thanks for watching.